everything that we do, we find in the scriptures what is taught. So if we say something, we have to be able to back it up. We have to be able to go to the scriptures to prove what we're saying is correct. First Corinthians 6:9-11. Do you not know that wicked will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived, neither the sexual immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor male prostitutes, nor homosexual offenders, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor slanderers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And that is what some of you were. But you were washed and were sanctified. You were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. In 1 Corinthians, in this passage, we find that God can forgive us of all of our sins, any sin that we've ever done, as long as we turn away from it. Because he says here that some of them were committing and living in a life of sin. He said, once you were once in that life, but you turned away from it. We can no longer live to sin. Romans 6:1-2. What shall we say then? Shall we go on sinning so that grace may increase? By no means. We died to sin. How can we live in it any longer? They say very clearly that we can no longer continue with the ways of the world. Once we accept and follow Christ, we have to turn away from it. We cannot return to it. We cannot continue in the life of sin. Now we find ourselves in a situation where we have learned we have sinned against God. Sinning against God is a penalty of eternal death. We are all guilty of sinning against God. Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. The gift of God is eternal life through Jesus. In Acts 2:38, Peter replied, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." What is the gift of the Holy Spirit? The gift of the Holy Spirit is eternal life. Not talking about some kind of miraculous power or some type of miraculous gift. He's talking about the gift that God gave us so that we can have eternity with Him because we have obeyed Him. Once we obey Him, He said we can have that gift. Paul reveals what we must do to have salvation after we understand the terrible condition of a life not in Jesus. We must be baptized. It is baptism that allows us to have remission of sins. We must die to sin. Acts 6:3. Romans 6:3. Or do you not know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into His death? Once we choose to be baptized, we're baptized into that death. We must be buried with Him. Romans 6:4.